But your Pantocrator Panagiatres, your Stotaniman, Shubiniman, So pray together, O Father, who art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Through Jesus Christ, the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, thank you for every condition, concerning every condition, For you have covered us, held us, accepted us, you spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
Pray that God may have mercy and compassion on us. Hear us, help us, and accept the supplications and prayers of his saints for that which is good on our behalf at all times, and to keep the life and standing of our honored father, Papa Avatawadros the Second, and his partner in the liturgy, our father, the Bishop Avadaniel, and his partner in the apostolic liturgy, our father, the Bishop Avayosef, and forgive us our sins.
Lord, have
and tekmet agathos pimairo omi misnan ethrin kokevol empai keo o es o apfai nem neho o tiro en tepen o Chen hirini niven, nem tekoti. Efsonos niven, pirasmos niven, en ergeia niven, en teb satanas. Psot shenin tehan rumi efhau, nem epton f eepshoyen tehan ga. Jini etip, nem ni es on hevol elitu evol harun, nem evol ha pekle ostirf, nem evol hatai ekeklesia thai. Nem evol ha paima eth owa كفاي نيزي اثنانيف نمني اتنو برصاني مؤنان جي انسوك بيتاك تيم برشيشنان اهو مي اجني هو اوف نمني اتشلي نم اجنتي قم تير سنت بيقا جي
Today we are blessed with His Grace Bishop Yusuf amongst us, and as well our beloved Father, His Grace Bishop Daniel. It's a very joyous and momentous occasion to have His Grace Bishop Yusuf. As you all know, His Grace is very, very eloquent and beautiful in His beautiful words that He always presents to us. And His Grace is very, very renowned for His fond love for hymnology as well and the rites of the church. So we're blessed to have His Grace amongst us. And we await to hear His words through the Holy Spirit on His words.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. I am happy to be with our beloved Father, His Grace Bishop Daniel, and with all the blessed Reverend Fathers of this blessed diocese, and with all of you tonight in this meeting for the deacons, in order to review with one another some principles about the service of the deaconate. I'm sure most of the things that I will mention today, you already know it. So it is a reminder about the importance of the spirituality in our service as a deacons. The first point I like to emphasize is deaconate is a responsibility and a talent that we will give an account before God for it. What do I mean by this? I remember one time I visited a person during my visitation. So he told me, Sayyidina, you ordained me 12 years ago as a deacon. So I told him, oh, that's great, but I don't see you serving as a deacon. I never served as a deacon since the day of my ordination. So I was surprised and told him, why? Why then did you accept to be ordained? He told me it's a blessing. So I said, let me get the blessing of the ordination, but this is not my gift or my talent. So I told him, do you know that being a deacon is a gift and a responsibility before God? And God actually will hold you accountable. And on the last day, he will tell you, give an account for your stewardship. So I want to emphasize that accepting to be ordained as a deacon, this means you are accepting the responsibility, and you should know that you will give an account before God. And I'm saying this also to the parents, because many parents, they like their children to be ordained, blessing. So they push their children to be ordained. And then they don't follow up with their children in order to be responsible and to be accountable for this responsibility. Actually, if you read the book of the ordination, you will find there is commandment to the deacons. And if the deacons, like the psalters, are young, there is another commandment to their parents. Because now the parents are responsible for their children. It is a responsibility before God. Yes, it's a blessing, but it is a responsibility. You know, I cannot say, okay, I will be ordained as a priest, you know, to get the blessing, but I will never actually act or participate or serve as a priest. You cannot do this. And when we speak about responsibility, responsibility means faithfulness and wisdom. In every day in the midnight hour in the third watch, the church reminds us with the word of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the faithful and wise steward. Why God expecting these two characteristics, faithfulness and wisdom? Think about it this way. If you have a business and you hired a manager to run your business, what do you expect from this manager? Actually, expect from him faithfulness and wisdom. Why? Let me assume if he is faithful but not wise, the business will lose because of the lack of wisdom. What about if he is wise but not faithful, not honest? He will make good profit, but he will steal the profit. That's why you need to hire a wise and a faithful steward. That's why the Lord said, who is the wise and faithful steward? So faithfulness in the service of deacon means you are faithful in learning the hymns of the church and the praises of the church, and to keep this heritage and this tradition. It will be very, very shameful that these hymns and these praises are kept for hundreds of years, maybe 600, maybe 1,000 years, maybe more, and then it disappeared at our time because no deacons are willing to keep this heritage. Not only to keep the heritage, but part of your faithfulness and wisdom, how to present this heritage to the people in a very acceptable way to help them to pray and to be engaged in prayer. Many times I'm surprised when we have a choir in the church. This choir, for example, will do a Christmas party or an Easter party or New Year party. So maybe they will be trained for 5-6 months in order to present this party in a very nice way so the people can enjoy it. And the deacons actually are like a choir, but we don't put this effort in order to help the people when they pray to be engaged in prayer. Again, part of your faithfulness and wisdom, not only to learn the hymn, but how to pray the hymn with spirituality. When the people find you praying with spirituality and all of you chant with one voice, this will engage the people in prayer. We say about the angels, they praise with one voice saying, and they are praising, they are chanting with the spirit of prayer. Also, your responsibility to translate the hymns and chant them in a language that the people can understand. It's very important, as St. Paul said, 5 words with understanding better than 1,000 words without understanding. Another element is your faithfulness in reading. Many times